actually present thought. Imagination thus includes more than the capacity to form those mental constructs that we normally consider to be imaginative. It includes memory and sense perception as well. Since it is clearly impossible to get around in the world without this, Spinoza conceives that it is in this way that I know almost all the things that are useful in life. That said, Spinoza consistently opposes imagination to intellect and views it as providing perception.
Right. He's going to reject that reason.
He says preferred terminology
could defeat
ideas
emotion.
Of the imagination are inadequate.
He's rejecting
the essential for getting around in the world, but they give us a distorted and incomplete picture of the things in it. To understand why, it is useful to begin with sense perception. That is the most important form of imaginative perception.
But he's rejecting
from this form that all others
derive. So I get it now on breath. What it boils down to, what breath, I'll just say boils down to,
is breath would just be another external
the pure
body.
Form of behavior.
So it is the body. But the body is what the idea of any mode in which the
behavior
human body is affected by external bodies must involve the nature of the human body.
By the
physical, and at the same time, the nature of the external body.
Or the imagination.
So the breath
but
is
never
just part of the lungs.
So what you're saying is, what I'm saying is that what breath boils down to is a pure form of behavior. So behavior is developed by the physical or the imagination, but never both at the same time. Now that does not make sense.
Each thing, as far as it can by its own power, strives to preserve and be. The correct interpretation of this principle is far from clear, but it appears to posit a kind of existential inertia within mode. Each mode, to the extent of its power, so acts to resist the destruction or diminution of its being. Spinoza expresses this by saying that each mode has an innate striving to preserve in being. The striving is so central to what a mode is that he identifies it as a mode's very essence. The striving by which each thing strives to preserve in its being is nothing but the actual essence of the thing. Though a bit of mysterious as to what it means to say that the striving of a mode is its essence, this identification will play a key role in Spinoza's ethical theory. Among other things, it will provide the basis upon which he can determine what is involved in living by the guidance of reason. Spinoza tells us that the model of human life, the life of the free man, is the one that is lived by the guidance of reason rather than under the sway of passions.
See, it should never make sense.
However,
it is chaotic,
it
forms from emotion and non-emotion, which exists alongside the physical imagination. To breathe is to be alive and nothing more. To not breathe is not to exist. But from its beginning, breath
nothing contrary to nature. It demands that
everyone
love himself, seek his own advantage.